Do you need a form that is so smart it can do calculations as people are entering data? Well, if so, you don't want to miss this video. I'm going to be going into detail on this very thing, so stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate your business. So if that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we do that, check the links below this video. And I would like to invite you to my upcoming live webinar. Once a week, I get on a live webinar and I showcase the fundamental building blocks of leveraging automation in your business. So if you're interested in learning how you can save up to 20 hours per week of your time, you don't want to miss that training. Even if you can't attend the training live, I will send you a replay of the training. So go ahead and sign up and I will see you in there. But without further ado, let's get to the heart of this video. We're talking about building a really cool and advanced form that uses calculations on the fly as people are entering data. Now, I want to start by actually taking a live example of this form, and then we're going to jump into the back end and look at how it's created. So the end result is this. People are able to enter their name. They enter their email. This is standard stuff. But here's where things get interesting. We've got a mileage that people are keying in. And depending on the miles that they put in, we're going to take a certain calculation or a certain action. And you'll notice in the notes below the mile field that we're saying if you're putting in less than 10 miles, you're going to get billed $2 per mile. If you're putting in more than 10 or more miles, you're going to get billed at a discounted rate. So you're getting like a bulk discount. If you're 10 or more, you're at $1.50 a mile. Less than 10, $2 a mile. Okay, so depending on what I put in here, I would expect to see a certain output. If I put in, let's say, 12 miles and I go to next, I'm taken to a page that says 10 miles or more. Obviously, there's some conditional logic on the back end, but you'll notice that I'm getting the calculation of 12 miles times 1.5, right? Because greater than 10 is multiplied by $1.5 per mile. And that's exactly what we get here. I'm asked to confirm that, where I'm then taken to a checkout page where I can enter in the amount that I owe and go ahead and check out on this. Now, we've done previous videos that showcase how you can leverage payment processing inside of JotForm. So look for those videos in the description below if you're interested on how to set all of that up. But the important part here is the conditional logic. How am I doing that calculation? Let's go back to the first page actually and see what happens if we put something in that's under 10. In this case, let's say I pick 8 miles. For this, we would expect it to direct us down a different path. We know that we're going to be charged $2 per mile, not $1.50 per mile. So I click next here and you see that sure enough, with 8 miles at $2 per mile, I'm taken to a different page, looks very similar, but it says under 10 miles. And the confirmation here is a different calculation, 8 times 2, 16. Again, when I click confirm, I go to that PayPal checkout page. So let's talk about how we set this all up and what the back end of this form really is all about. In order to get there, I'm going to pop back into the actual form itself. And you'll notice that I have 4 different pages before the thank you page. Now, the first page is pretty straightforward. It's asking all those input variables. What's your name? What's your email? And what is the mileage that you're putting in for this particular entry? And then it's directing us to page 2. Page 2 is the under 10 miles. And here we have what we call a form calculation. Now you can access the form calculation inside of JotForm by going to the widgets. Over here on the left-hand panel, click on widgets and access the form calculation. And when you enter this element in, you get your widget settings. And this is where you can actually enter some sort of calculation that's going to happen on the form. In this case, I'm adding the field of total miles. So you have access to all of the fields previously in the form. And since we have our preceding field here called total miles, I'm able to use that in this calculation. The next part of that is to then bring in the multiplication and enter in whatever I'm multiplying it by. Now in this particular page, this is under 10 miles, which we say is going to be billed at $2 per mile. So that's where I get that $2. And one thing to note is that you must make sure that this is being treated as a number, not as a string. So you see down at the bottom here that you have some color coding. It's going to tell you how JotForm is going to interact with this. So you want to make sure that JotForm takes this as a number because we're performing arithmetic. Go ahead and save those settings. And then what we want to do is pass that information along into the next part of our form, which is this output that simply states how much the person will be billed. So we can pass along the variable here that is entered into this field. Now, in order to find that, go into the properties of this field, click on over to advanced, and expand the field details here. This unique name right here is how we reference this particular field and how we can pass it on into other parts of our form. So calculation 412, this is case sensitive, and it has to be included inside of those squiggly brackets. So make sure you grab that. And I've just entered that very text here inside of my output paragraph below this element. Now, one other thing that I should point out is that I've hidden this element. So back in the advanced properties of the form calculation, I've opted to hide this. And this is because if I don't hide it, people can make changes to that number. And of course, that kind of throws everything out of whack. I don't want them to be able to change what that number is. I want that calculation to be based on the number of miles they entered in the previous question. Now, it should come as no surprise that my next page is going to be really very similar to this. In fact, it's just a copy with some alterations made. The difference here is this is for 10 miles or more. And the calculation here, of course, is if it's over 10, right? Greater than or equal to 10 miles. And in this case, in my widget settings, of course, I'm multiplying it by 1.5. So pretty similar, have to follow all the same rules, but of course the calculation is different. So once I've saved this, I can go into the properties down here and also back over to advanced and down to the field details. I can pull out that unique name here and I can make sure that it's showing up in my text underneath this element. Similarly, I've chosen to hide this calculation element so that people on the form can't make changes. So I now have two pages which are relatively identical, one of them for under 10 miles, one of them for 10 miles or more. Now the last piece that I need to do is build the logic in my form. In order to do that, I head on over to settings. Inside of my settings, on the left side, I can find the conditions. And I build conditions that simply say, depending on what we receive for that total mileage input variable, then I want to go to a certain page or hide other pages. So let's take a look at these conditions one at a time. We'll start with our total miles less than 10. We simply say, in the total miles field, remember that's our fourth question, if it is less than the value of 10, then I will hide page 3. Page 3 is the field that is built for greater than or equal to 10, so of course I don't want to show it if the total mileage is under 10. Once I've saved that, I can go into my other condition, and it's going to be the same but the opposite. Inside of this one, I simply say, if total miles is equal to 10, or if total miles is greater than 10. So this is a little confusing because there is not a greater than or equal to option as you might expect there to be. Instead, what I have to do is put out both conditions and say if either one of them is matched, that is, if it's equal to 10 or if it's greater than 10. So if either of those conditions are matched, then I will be hiding page 2 being the page that, of course, is built for less than 10 miles. So it's pretty straightforward. Once we have it all set up, we simply save this, and then again, we can take that out for a spin and confirm that it goes to the places that we would expect. So starting at the top of the form, we can experiment with a few different mileage options. Anything 10 or greater is going to take us to the 10 miles or more page and apply the appropriate math, 1.5 times 10. Or if it's under 10, let's say it's 7, then we're taken to the under 10 miles page. And of course, in this case, it's multiplied by 2. So 7 times 2, 14. Very cool use case for you if you have math that has to be performed under certain conditions in your form. I hope you see how this allows your form to be really smart and do that math on the fly as people enter information. I hope you got a ton of value from this. Let me know what questions you have below in the chat, and I will see you in the next video.
As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon. Thank you.